Picture perfect. We're used to it on TVs and billboards and in magazines. Heck, there are apps that allow us to hide behind our imperfections. But there has been some pushback on this in the last few years. The naked face movement caught on in Hollywood and has continued to spread.
Yeah, this week CVS says it's going to put its best face forward on the issue. As Adrienne Brada shows us, the drugstore is saying so long to Photoshop.
In a world with unlimited filters to help enhance the perfect photo, CVS is filtering the way you see models on its beauty brands. The company announced it will no longer Photoshop pictures on its beauty products. But is this a good move by CVS?
I think that was a really, really great move. I'm really impressed that they are willing to take that stance.
Dr. Michael O'Sullivan is a psychiatrist with the Line of Health. He says this move changes the body image conversation, not just for women, but for men too.
Primarily affects women. I think often the advertising and social media aspects also focus more on body image for women. Men tend to what we call orthorexia, or like this perfect body that may not be realistic at all. And they start to compare themselves. Even if someone is in a very normal weight that's very healthy, they see that they're not exactly like someone else.
Later this year, CVS will add a watermark, what it's calling a beauty mark, to images that haven't been significantly retouched. CVS says this move is part of a greater commitment to use original photos, unfiltering a distorted reality.
How do some of these Photoshopped images or even applying filters change the perception of beauty?
I think right now there's kind of this unrealistic presentation of beauty. It's something that kind of no one, it's not physically possible to attain. And that does lead to negative self-image, or it can. If people aren't kind of aware of it, nobody has a bad day. Everyone's smiling. It's not just the physical appearance, but it's kind of the emotional impact of these images as well.
What's the best way for teens and adults to improve their self-esteem and just overall feel good about their body image?
I think people being aware that these images aren't real. It's just being aware that it's not physically possible to attain these images is the first step. Once people know, like, that's not possible to look that way, they won't attempt to look that way and won't feel bad.
We've heard a lot about body image, but the more I thought about that story, I try so many different things. The older we get, you know, like lotions and potions for your face so it doesn't look like that. And those photos that you see, I'm like, how much money have I spent on products just to not age?
Right.
It's different. I mean, body image, I guess, encompasses all that, but I appreciate that because I'm like, just show me what her face looks like.
But do you, I wonder though, if there's our generation who grew up just watching all these, you know, constant retouches and things.
Easy breezy, beautiful cover girl.
Right. But this generation that is coming up now knows that nobody looks like that because everybody has a filter. They do it themselves. Yeah. So I wonder if they get that that's not an attainable reality because they know it's not real. Where folks from our generation are like, how does she look so fantastic?
Good question.
I don't know. I don't know.
Young people, if you
everywhere.
Have a television, that one young person that has one, can you let us know? That'd be great. All right.